Hi guys, welcome back. I'm Vivek Singhal from tradingwithvivek.com, and today we are going to discuss about that how to create equity portfolio for long-term wealth creation. So here in this video, I'm going to tell you exactly step-by-step action plan how to create a long-term equity portfolio for long-term wealth creation. So watch the video carefully, because each and every step is very important. But before moving ahead, whatever stocks we would be discussing here, those would be just for educational purpose, and these would work as an example, and it's not a recommendation to buy or sell any of those stocks. And second, if you have yet not subscribed my channel, just subscribe, because I will keep on moving more educational videos like this just to polish our trading skills and investing skills. So let's move on. Number one, we need to find out 10 sectors those have a very good growth prospect over a period of next 10 years. So 10 sectors we need to find out, and I have found out these 10 sectors. You can edit the list of those sectors according to your knowledge and according to your feeling that one or more sectors can be added or removed or added into this list. But here is my list of 10 sectors. Sector number 1 IT, number 2 MNC Pharma, number 3 Paint Industries, number 4 Banking, number 5 Insurance, number 6 mutual fund AMC, number 7 wearable goods, number 8 electronic goods, number 9 personal care, number 10 fast moving foods. So these are 10 sectors. I do feel like that these 10 sectors would be growing much more faster, and these 10 sectors have good growth potential over a period of next 10 years. So these are 10 sectors. Now let's find out two major market leaders or leading companies among these sectors. So here I have chosen these 20 stocks, means two stocks from one industry, which we have selected 10 industries. So here's the list of those 20 stocks. In IT, we have chosen TCS and Infosys. In paint, this is Asian Paints and Berger Paints. In insurance, HDFC Life and ICICI General Insurance. In MNC, pharma companies, Abbott and Glaxo Pharma. Among banking, HDFC Bank and Kotak Bank. In personal care, this is Procter and Gamble and Hindustan Unilever. In fast moving foods, Nestle and Britannia. In wearing, Bata and Page Industries. In mutual fund, AMC, HDFC, AMC and Nippo Asset Management. And electronic goods, this is Havells and Whirlpool. So these 20 companies are among the market leaders of 10 growing sectors which we have chosen. So the third condition here is that all these 20 companies among these 10 sectors must be generating 20% return on capital employed, ROCE, because if these companies are able to generate 20% ROCE, then there is no question mark on the management's capability, which is an important factor to consider whenever we are going to have an investment. So 10 sectors, 20 companies, and all these must be generating 20% ROCE, more than 20%. So the greater is better. Now the next question comes, when to buy? Let's make it very simple, and it's very simple if we buy it below 200 day moving average. So below 200 day moving average, I have always seen that this is the buying area for value investors, especially in these great companies. These companies there are very less chances, means very occasionally these companies comes down below 200 day moving average, because these are from fast moving sectors and these are great companies. But there are reasons those are created in the market to bring these companies down below 200 day moving average. Right now there are almost 7 companies those are available below 200 day moving average out of these 200 companies. So here is the list of those 7 companies. Number one, Procter & Gamble. Number two, Bata. Number three, Page Industries. Number four, HDFC AMC. Number five, Nippo Asset Management. Number six, Asian Paints. And number seven, Kotak Bank. So these are seven companies. Those are available. So if we do start, building up the portfolio, so these companies can be bought. According to the examples, again, it's not a recommendation, but according to the criteria we are setting here. So we can add these companies here. Now the second part is we need to keep on adding, we need to keep on investing every month some amount. So let's, for example, we should invest at least 10% of our monthly income on regular basis in equity portfolio just to create a very good wealth over a period of time. So at the end of the month, whenever we do get our salary or we do get our income, let's have a look again at these 20 companies, that which company is trading below 200 a moving average. And if these are three companies at that particular moment, those are trading below 200 a moving average, divide equally in three parts that in amount which we want to invest in these companies, and invest that, and keep on doing that. So the next part comes, that when to get out or when to sell any of the stocks we do have. So either of these three things if happen, then we should get out of the stock. If that sector that company belongs to is no more a growth sector. Number two, if the company is not among the market leaders now. And number three, if the company is unable to generate more than 20% return on capital employed. So we should get out of that stock, and we should find out a new company meeting all these three requirements, and we should keep on doing this. So if we with risk management, if we do take these steps, I'm sure that a immense wealth will be created over a period of time. And this is not difficult to do this exercise. I do know that trading is much more rewarding than any kind of investment on a systematic basis, but trading requires a lot of time, and everybody is not able to find out that much of time because they are busy in their own job, which is their regular work. So this kind of investment is a very good alternative, because here we are not buying anything at any price and later on feeling or being regretful that this was the wrong investment decision. We are investing on a very systematic basis. We are taking great companies from growing sectors with great management, and most important, at a lower prices. So this was for the day. If you keep on doing this, I hope that a good wealth would be generated over a period of time. So I am Vivek Singhal from tradingwithvivek.com. Keep on watching, keep on learning, and again, if you have not subscribed yet, do subscribe the channel, do thumbs up if you like the video, and till the next video, take care, have a good day. Thank you.